Hello dear students, I am Sahana Prasad from Department of Commerce, Gopal Swami PU College, Mysore. In today's session of Business Studies, let's continue with Chapter 10, that is Internal Trade. And today's topic is Retail Trade. In previous session, I explained the concept of Wholesale Trade. In this session, let's try to understand the concept of Retail Trade. Normally, retailer buys goods from wholesalers in large quantities and then sells it to ultimate customers in smaller quantities. Retailing is a branch of business which is engaged in sale of goods and service directly to ultimate customers for their personal use or for non-business purpose. Iga retail trade athwa retailing business andre goods na avaru wholesaler inda large quantity nalli purchase maadkondo adana smaller quantities alli customers ge sale madodanna naavu retail trade anta karitivi. See, there may be different ways of selling goods. Goods can be sold through either telephone or through vending machine, or products can be sold at different places or in a provision store or door to door service or at a customer's place. You would have seen a salesman coming to your place and selling a few goods, for example, pen or mirrors or towels or cosmetics or detergent powder, etc. And you can also see the sale of vegetables and fruits by the farmers. As long as these goods are sold to ultimate customers, this is considered as retail trade. Here, how the goods are sold and where the goods are sold doesn't matter. Unless and until if a business sells its goods and services to ultimate customer, it is considered as retail selling. Here, retailer, he also performs various functions, like he collects goods from wholesalers and he arranges it properly in his store. He sells those goods in smaller quantities and even he bears a lot of risk. He grades the product, he collects market information and he extends a credit to the buyers. He also promotes products through a display of products or by offering them a gift coupon or a discount, etc. Now let us see what are the services of retailers. Services of retailers. Retailers gives services to manufacturers and wholesalers, and we also see what are the services which are given by the retailers to customers. Now let us see the services of retailers given to manufacturers and wholesalers. First is help in distribution of goods. First function or first service which is provided by the retailers to manufacturers and wholesalers is they help in distribution of goods and services. The main job of retailers is to sell goods and service to ultimate customers. So the products which are manufactured by the manufacturer, that is purchased by wholesaler, and wholesaler, he sells it to retailers and retailers sells it to ultimate customers. Here, retailer, he make the product available to the customers. Customers, you know, they are scattered over a large geographical area. So this gives place utility. Ivaga illi main function yenu retailer kodtirodu andre goods na distribute maado ondu function na perform martare. Ivaga customers ella kade irodrinda ivaga retailers ella kade nu irthare. So retailers ivaga customers ella kade nu geographical area li irodrinda products ellargu talpo hage retailers nodkoltare. So this is the first service which is given by the retailers to manufacturers and wholesalers. Second one is personal selling. Here retailer, he make effort to sell the product to the customers. Here personal selling comes into picture. Here retailer, he relieve the wholesalers and manufacturers in personal selling. Personal selling is an activity which is engaged by retailers. So retailers or customers ke personal aage goods na sell marta. So that is personal selling. Here the manufacturers and the wholesalers, they need not think of selling the products which they have manufactured. So personal selling, it is an effort which has to be made by the retailer. Third one is enabling large scale operations. Enabling large scale operations. Here, retailers, they relieve the wholesalers and manufacturers to sell the products to ultimate customers so that they can concentrate on production only, especially manufacturers. Here, wholesalers and manufacturers, they need not think of selling the product so that they can fully concentrate on their own activity. Manufacturing people, they can concentrate on manufacturing the products, and wholesalers, they can do their job freely. So this is how retailers, they enable large scale operations. Fourth one is collecting market information. Retailers are those who are in direct touch with customers. So when customer comes to his shop, he can analyze what kind of products customer usually prefer, what kind of features few customer expect from a particular product. All these kinds of information are collected by the retailers, and that information he will pass to the manufacturers and wholesalers. So here he collects all kinds of marketing information. So that is collecting market information. Next is help in promotion. Help in promotion means here manufacturers and distributors, in order to increase the sale of their products, they conduct various promotional activities. So in these activities, retailers participate in these activities, and retailers help the manufacturers and distributors to increase the sale of the product. For example, they may conduct a sale contest, or they may offer discount, or they may offer some gift coupon, or they may conduct few promotional activities. In all these activities, retailers participate and they help manufacturers and distributors to increase the sale of their product. So this is help in promotion. So these are the services which are given by the retailers to manufacturers and wholesalers. First one is the help in distribution of goods. Second is personal selling. Third one is enabling large scale operations. Fourth one is collecting market information. Fifth one is the help in promotion. Now let us see what are the services which are given by retailers to consumers. Consumers means customers. Regular availability of products. First service which is given by the retailer to consumer is regular availability of products. Whenever a customer comes to his shop, he makes sure that whatever product he asks for, it will be available at his shop. So again, a customer or angdig bandru nuve adu product or ಏನು ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅದು ರೆಡಿಯಾಗಿ ಅವ್ನ ಶಾಪಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗೋ ಥರ ಒಂದು ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿನ ರೀಟೇಲರು ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಎನೇಬಲ್ಸ್ ದ ಬಾಯರ್ ಟು ಬೈ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ನೀಡ್. ಸೊ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದಾಗ ಅವರು ರೀಟೇಲರ್ ಹತ್ರ ಬಂದು ಅವ್ರು ಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ನ ಕೊಂಡ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್. Retailers are those who give information about new products which are available in the market. He provide all kinds of information to customers. ಇವಾಗ ಯಾವ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಹೊಸದು ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಅದ್ರದ್ದು ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಏನು, ಅದನ್ನು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಅದರಿಂದ ಏನೇನು ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜಸ್ಸು, ಎಲ್ಲ ಥರದ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ರೀಟೇಲರು ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಹೀ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಯಾವ ಹೊಸ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲನೂ ನೀಟಾಗಿ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವ್ನು ಅಂಗಡಿಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸು ಕೊಂಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಥರ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ರೀಟೇಲರು ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ buying. Convenience in buying means, you know, retailers, they purchase goods from manufacturers in a large quantity and they sell in smaller quantities to customers. And you know, retailers are, they are scattered over a, even they are scattered over a large geographic area. You know, retailers are usually situated in residential areas and they remain open for longer. So that this makes the customer, it is convenient for the customer to buy the product as and when it is required. So convenience in buying andre ivaga retailers alli irthare, residential areas alli irthare, so alli jaasti avasu or angdina open maadi ittkondirtare. So customers yavaga bekadru bando avaru bekagira products na bando purchase maadkolbodu. That is convenience in buying. Fourth one is wide selection. Generally retailers, they keep the stock of varieties of goods. And this makes the customers to select the products whichever he wants, and he will have choice in selecting the goods. So that is wide selection. Ivag retailers, manufacturers in the bekadashtara products, adralli varieties of products na tandu angli itkondirtare. So customers bandaga avarge choice irutte, so that avarge bekagira samanana avaru tagolbodu. So that is wide selection. Next is after sale services. Retailers provide after sale service to customers. In what way? They may offer a home, a free home delivery of the products. They may supply the spare parts of a few products, and by attending the customers, all these are services which are provided by the retailers to customers. It is after sale service. Ivaga sale madad mele goods customers ke free home delivery kodabodu. Ivaga tumba saman tagondirtare, so avargellaru tagonogak agala anta manege naavu tan kodtivi anta one service kodabodu. Spare parts kodtivi antanu helbodu. So ee tara ella service kottaga enagutte, purchase repeat agutte. Here the buyers, they may decide to repeat the purchase of the product. So that is after sale services. Provide credit facilities. Provide credit facilities. Retailers, they often provide credit facilities to customers, especially to regular buyers. So obviously this will increase in the level of consumption, and of course it will lead to a standard of living. Credit facilities chaala kuda kodtare customers ke. So adana navu provide credit facilities anta karithivi. So these are the various services which are given to the consumers by retailers. First one is regular availability of goods and service. Second is new product information. Third is convenience in buying. Fourth one is wide selection. Fifth one is after sale service. And sixth one is provide credit facilities. Next is types of retailing trade. Types of retailing trade. There are different types of retailing trade. Classification of this retailing trade can be done on the basis of size of business, whether it is small business or medium business or large business, or on the basis of ownership, whether it is sole proprietorship or partnership or a cooperative store or a company. Similarly, on the basis of mercantilized handle, different classifications can be made, like a specialty store or a departmental store or supermarket, etc. On common basis, classification of retailing trade is done whether or not they have fixed place of business. On this basis, there are two categories. First one is itinerant retailers. Itinerant retailers. Second is fixed shop retailers. See, this classification is done on the basis of whether they have fixed place of business or not. So now let us see what are itinerant retailers and fixed shop retailers. In this session, I am going to explain about itinerant retailers. In next session, I am going to explain about fixed shop retailers. Now let us try to understand what is itinerant retailers. Itinerant retailers are those retailers who do not have fixed place of business. They keep on moving from one place to another place along with their wares from street to street or place to place in search of customers. So, ಅವ್ರು ಏನು ಅವ್ರು ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ನ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಒಂದು ಜಾಗದಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಜಾಗಕ್ಕೆ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಬೀದಿನ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬೀದಿಗೆ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ನ ಹುಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅದು ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ನಾವು ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಐಟಿನರೆಂಟ್ ರೀಟೈಲರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಐಟಿನರೆಂಟ್ ರೀಟೈಲರ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್. ದ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ and they are very small traders who sell the goods, and they usually deal with the products of daily use. Daily use, for example, soap, toothbrush, toothpaste, yeah, that is toiletry products, fruits and vegetables, etc. ಸೊ ಐಟಿನರೆಂಟ್ ರಿಟೈಲರ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಅವರು ಯಾವ ಥರ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ನ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೈಲಿ ಯೂಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಆಟ್ ಡೋರ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಐಟಿನರೆಂಟ್ ರಿಟೈಲರ್ಸ್ they provide services to the customers at the doorstep. Aur manege hogi aur mane baglallene hogi avaru goods na sale martare. They provide greater customer service by selling the goods at the doorstep of the customers. So this is the third feature. And they keep limited inventory. Limited inventory means they will not have more stock of products because they'll be keep on moving from one place to another place. So these retailers, they have to keep their inventory or that is stock limited, and they have to keep this at their home, they have to keep it at some other place. So this is fourth one. So these are the characteristics of itinerant retailers. So they are basically small traders who have limited resource. And also they deal with the products of daily use, that is, as I said, toiletry products, fruits, vegetables, etc. And they make products available at the doorstep of customers. And fourth one is limited inventory. They can't keep more stock of goods because they'll be keep on moving from one place to another place. Now let us see what are the types of itinerant retailers. First one is peddlers and hawkers. Peddlers and hawkers are oldest type of retailing sellers. They do not have fixed place. They keep on moving from one place to another place, especially in a bicycle or a hand cart or a cycle rickshaw or on their heads. In order to sell the products at the doorstep of the customers, they usually carry the products on a bicycle or a cycle rickshaw or on their heads. They usually deal with the non-standardized products, that is non-branded products, or you can also say that they deal with local brands and products of low value, for example toys, vegetables and fruits, fabrics, carpets, snacks, ice cream, etc. You can find these peddlers and hawkers especially in residential areas, places of exhibition, outside school, especially during lunch break. And one must be careful with them, especially if they buy the products from peddlers and hawkers. They are not always reliable in terms of quality and price. Ratra tagola products ashtu olle quality nalli illade irbodu because it is of low quality and it is non-standardized, non-branded products. Those kinds of products are sold by peddlers and hawkers. So peddlers and hawkers andre avaru ಇವಾಗ ಅವ್ರ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ, ನಾನ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡೆಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡೈಸ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟಾಯ್ಸ್, ಫ್ರೂಟ್ಸ್, ವೆಜಿಟೇಬಲ್ಸ್, ಸ್ನ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್, ಐಸ್ ಕ್ರೀಮ್ಸ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಸೈಕಲಲ್ಲಾಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ರಿಕ್ಷಾಲಾಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಅವ್ರ ತಲೆ ಮೇಲಾಗಲಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಪೆಡ್ಲರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಾಕರ್ಸ್ನ ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಇನ್ ರೆಸಿಡೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಷನ್ ಆರ್ ನಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಲಂಚ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್. So this is peddlers and hawkers. Second one is market traders. Market traders are those kind of retailer who open their shop especially on a particular day. or during a particular time. For example, on every Saturday or alternative Sundays like that. Even these traders, even they deal with products like fabrics or ready-made garments or toys or crockery. Usually they are general merchants. And usually they provide service to lower income group, of customers. And they usually deal with low priced products, especially which are in daily use. So daily use madantha products na avaru sale maartta hogtare. So ivaga market traders andre avaru particular days alli ivaga every Saturday no athwa alternative Sundays o avaru shop na open maadkoltare. So they open their shop at different places. ಒಂದೇ ಕಡೆ ಇರಲ್ಲ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿ ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಇಟಿನರೆಂಟ್ ರಿಟೇಲರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್. ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಪೇವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವೆಂಡರ್ಸ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ವೇರ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್, in a places like railway station or bus stand or a city market, etc. And they usually sell the items like, you know, stationery items, eatables, ready-made garments, magazines, mirrors, towels, etc. And these street traders, they are a little bit different from market traders because they do not change their places frequently. Market traders, they keep on changing the place of their business. But street traders, they do not change the place of the business too frequently as in case of market traders. ಅವರು ಯೂಶಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಜನ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ನ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇವಾಗ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ಝಿನ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಸ್ಟೇಷ್ನರಿ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಈಟೇಬಲ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಆ ಥರದನ್ನು ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಯು ನೋ ಬಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ರೈಲ್ವೆ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿಟಿ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್. ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಚೀಪ್ ಜ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್. ಚೀಪ್ ಜ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಶಾಪ್ which is of temporary in nature, and you can find them in a business locality. And these cheap jacks, they keep on changing the place of business from one place to another place depending upon the potentiality of the area. Yelli avarge jaasti vyapara agutte alli ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅವರು ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ನ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇವಾಗ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ದಿನ ಒಂದು ಏರಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೂ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅವ್ರ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಜಾಗ ಹುಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಶಾಪ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಡೀಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಪೇರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಚಸ್, ಶೂಸ್, ಬಕೆಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ದ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪೆಡ್ಲರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಾಕರ್ಸ್. They do have a fixed place, but they may change the place of business depending upon the potentiality of the area. So, ivaga ondu temporary aagi avaru ondu angdina itkoltare. Ivaga watch repair madodirbodu athwa shoe repair madodirbodu. So, idellanu kelava examples cheap jacks ke. So, these are the different types of itinerant retailers: peddlers and hawkers, market traders, street traders and cheap jacks. So, in this session, I have explained the topic retail trade, and I hope you have understood today's session. Thank you.